Every Abacus deflux welding tutorial I found was either too vague or they just hit the actual code. So I made this. This is the only video you'll need. We're starting completely from scratch, first building the model in Abacus, then writing the deflux subroutine, setting up the moving heat source, and simulating the weld step by step. And yes, you'll get the entire code. Before we start, a quick thanks to the video's sponsor, Heatshape. Heatshape is a cloud-based simulation platform made for welding and additive manufacturing. No installations, no custom codings, just pick your process, define your weld path, and run the simulation right from your browser in a few clicks. If you're tired of debugging subroutines and want to run your simulations without headaches, this software is for you. I put the link in a pinned comment down below. Check them out on LinkedIn or their website to try this software for free. Now let's get started. Go to the part. 3D deformable solid extrusion, 0.2 would be okay. Now we want to create a rectangle. This is the rectangle. Let's put this guy on 0.025, this one 0.05. Done, and 0.50, and this is the part we have. Now let's create partition here. For this purpose, I click on partition face sketch, select this one, and vertical right. I just need two lines here like this, because I want to refine the mesh here in the center where the flux moves. Okay, now we need to extrude that. Left click and hold and select this one, partition cell, extrude slash sweep. So select this one, by holding shift you can select the other one. Done, sweep along edge, this one, and create partition. Okay, we need to have the flux here and moves in this region. Now we can go to the property, create materials properties. We need general density, temperature dependent. We need thermal conductivity, temperature dependent. And we need a specific heat, temperature dependent. Now let's go to the Excel file to copy and paste them. Control C. This is for the density, conductivity. And specific heat. This is the material properties we need. And now we need to create a section. The section must be solid, homogeneous, and okay, it should be material one. And we can assign it to this one. I uncheck this. Okay, as it turns green, it means the section is assigned. Now let's go to the assembly. I assembled the model here. Now I need to translate it. I want to translate it from here to here. Scroll button. I reset the view. So the reason I translate it to here is because in my code, I want to define here as a starting point, which is the 0, 0, 0, and it's easier for me to do that. Okay, we can go to the step. We need to create a step. The step should be heat transfer, comes after the step initial, continue. The time period can be 25, so this one is better to be 1 million, so this can be 0.1. 1e-10 is enough, and that can be 1. This can be 350. Okay, now we're almost done. We go to the field output. We only need the nodal temperature. We don't need the heat flux, we don't need anything, just the nodal temperature. Now the step is also done. Let's go to the interaction. We need to create the interaction. The first interaction I want to create is in step 1, and is surface film condition. I want to create the surface here because I need it for the next one. I select everything, then rotate it. By holding Control, you can uncheck the bottom part. And done. So it should be property reference, and from here I can create properties. And as this is the film condition, I can go to the continue and create the film condition. Here I need the surface film coefficient, copy, jump back to abacus and paste. Okay, the sink temperature can be 25, interaction properties, and this is a film condition. Okay, now we need to create another one, which is surface radiation. You can select it from surfaces here, surface one. If you hit on highlight, you can see the part you selected. Continue. The emissivity must be 0.49 and the ambient temperature is 25. Okay, I reset the view and we're done with the interaction. Now it's time to go to the load. This time I want to create the load. Surface heat flux in step one, continue, and I need this surface. I don't want to create any more sets, so done. And this time, instead of uniform, we use user defined. And when we use user defined, in the end, we need to have the deflux as it says here. The node user subroutine deflux must be attached to the analysis job. We put the value of 1 for this, and okay, as you see, the load is created here. Another thing we can do here is to define the predefined field. In step 1, other and field, select everything, done. The magnitude can be 25. By creating a predefined field, the initial temperature of the model is 25. Now the load is finished, we can go to the mesh. Okay, now we put this on part. The global mesh size can be 0.002. And okay, we need to seat the edges. By holding shift, I select these four and these four. I want to have 40 elements here, and on this one, the one in the bottom here, this one and this one, I can have 6 elements and done. And here and every line which is parallel to it, we need to have 4 elements. And done. Let's mesh it and see how it goes. Actually, the meshes, the elements here are a little big, but it's okay for now. Now let's go to assign element type, select everything, and go all the way down and select the heat transfer and click on OK. Now we need to create a job. Name it welding deflux and continue. From here we need to use the subroutine. Now this is the time to write down the code. First thing first, we need to open the Visual Studio. If you don't know how to link your abacus with Fortran, just let me know in the comments down below. I can create a video for that. So we go continue without code, and from here file, new and file. I want to create Intel Fortran and .4 file. I open it. Now this is the file I have. Now we need to go to the abacus documentation. Now here in Abacus, if you go all the way down to the user subroutines, and we need the Abacus standard user subroutines and deflux. This is the code for the deflux, so I always recommend you to copy and paste it from here. Don't trust any other sources. Then you go back here and paste it. As you see here, we have subroutine deflux, and here is where we need our code. Okay, I zoom it out to let you take a screenshot or write it down yourself. I'm going to talk about it. Here we have the coordinates, chords 1, 2, and 3 are x, y, and z. Accordingly, time 2 is the actual time step we have in the module of step. So time 2 is the step, and this is t. We have x0, y0, and z0. So I don't need the y0 here because we only working with the x and z, as this is a surface heat flux. So here, as you see here, we have x and we have z here. Okay, we have the welding speed v, we have the power, and we have the radius of the spot. So imagine if it's a laser welding, this would be the radius of welding spot. And we have the famous pi 3.14. Here in this section, we define the movement. The z is z0. It means we don't move in the z direction, but we move in the x direction with the speed of v in the time of t. This is our model. We don't have any movement in the z direction or y direction. We only move in x direction with the speed of v. Okay, here is the Gaussian surface heat flux we have. R02 is optional, but it makes your coding easier. So instead of writing R0 to the power of 2 here or here or here, you just write it down here. And we have the distribution here, which is the equation we have, x minus xc to the power of 2 and z minus zc to the power of 2. And here we have the q, which is 3 times q pi and so on. I wrote down the equation here. This is the Gaussian distribution. Q, 3q over pi r2 exp of minus 3 times x minus xc to the power of 2 z minus zc to the power of 2 over r2. So it should be the center of the torch and decays rapidly with the distance from the center. Basically, this model is a Gaussian distribution, that is a fancy name for a bell curve, a smooth symmetrical peak that rapidly falls off as you move away from the center. The equation would be something like this. We have the power, we have the exponential part. And here in the beginning, the flux one is zero. Then we wrote down the F here. And why did we write down the F here? Is because this is a cutoff check. In this manner, we would like to save our power. Instead of running the whole simulation in the whole model, it's greater than R0, we don't need the calculation. So we write down this if to make that happen. And if you wonder why I use LT here, it means less than. So if the distance to less than R02, then the flux one is Q0 and we don't have the flux 2. Or you can write it down something like this: if x minus xc to the power of 2 z minus zc to the power of 2 is less than r0, or you can say dist 2 less than r0, then whichever is easier for you. Okay, we want to save this one. Save welding deflux, and I can name it deflux. Make sure it should be deflux.for. Okay, we go back to Abacus. Before we submit the job, we need to go to the model, edit attributes, and model 1. This is minus 273.15, and 7 Boltzmann is 5.669 E minus 8, and okay, now we need to create a job. I can name it welding deflux practiced. Continue. In general here, use user subroutine file. This is welding deflux, deflux for. Okay, but before we submit a job, I want to ask you a favor. If you enjoyed this video so far, please let me know your feedback in the comments down below. It's totally free for you, but it means a lot for me and helped me grow and makes me motivated to create more videos like this. Okay, let's submit a job. As you see, the job is running. I stop the video and resume after the job is completed. Now the job is completed. Let's go and take a look at the results quickly. I can hit the plot contour. This is the final. Let's take a look at the animation. As you see, the flux is moving smoothly and the temperature is somewhere around 2600, which is pretty reasonable. Let's see if it can reaches the end with the time we adjusted for it. Yep. And okay, if you go to the option common and free edges, we can see the flux movement even better. And there's a wavy motion of the flux here. It's because of the big elements. If we refine the elements, it would be moving better. But for now, it's okay because we just only wanted to show you how deflux subroutine works. Now, I want to put it somewhere here. For instance, I don't want the animation. Now, if we go to the XY data, ODP field output, continue here. Instead of integration point, we can go for unique nodal, nodal temperature, and we can pick from the viewport, for instance, here. And we can plot it. And as you see here, we plotted the temperature versus time. And that's it. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe to the channel to see more videos like this. And if you don't want to do the welding simulation with subroutine, click on the video before it ends. Stay tuned.